is lecture number 10 and the topic is major barriers in implementing a policy in There are three major barriers in implementing a policy in Pakistan: the ambitious policy goals, lack of political will, and the third one is faulty governance and lack of resources. So first of all, I would say I would give you some background. So education policy in Pakistan, as in other developing countries, faces the challenge of poor implementation. The here I would say the history of education policy in Pakistan describes the conventional accounts of policy failures. It particularly highlights the issues of unclear goals, political commitment, governance, centralization, resources, and foreign aid. Generally, it is assumed that overcoming these challenges will result in better policy outcomes. Although this is partially true, but not the whole true. And I would say that they argued that implementing agents try to make sense of policy provisions before acting on them. I would say, like, all the departments and institutions of Pakistan have their own policies, and they have to face the barriers, the challenges regarding their department and institutions. So whether it is education department, whether it is health department, whether it is some other department, they have to follow some they have their goals, they have to set the target, they have to achieve their goals, and they have to face the challenges and other barriers. So the major barriers I have written: the ambitious policy goals, lack of political will, and faulty governance and lack of resources. Ambitious policy goals, it means sometimes the policy has made, okay, and but the targets you have set in that policy that you have to achieve at the end of the policy implementation, we can say in evaluation. So but the desired results, if the desired results are not achieved, so the policy sometimes automatically like cancelled or not implemented. So whatever the budget or the money the government has spent over that policy, that is that went wastage, and that always goes wastage if the implementation of that policy is not made effectively. So the next is lack of political will. It means like we all know that when when a government takes when a political party, I must say, takes over the government, so it has its own targets, own goals they have to set in, and they have to achieve them in their 5 years of tenure. So then comes they have to achieve them, but if they fail to achieve the their goals and like their targets, so that becomes the lack of political will. So then comes it's an attempt to pull together various threads in the academic literature on political will into one clear definition. So it's a structural way to determine where and when political will exists, and if it does not, what exactly is missing. It also illuminates why in current hyper-polarized US politics, political will is so hard to come by. I found it it is quite helpful, so I thought I would share it. There is a distribution of preferences. Basically, I'm talking about political will. What is political will basically? So there is a distribution of preferences which has to do with who wants what. There is the authority, capacity, and legitimacy of key decision makers or reformers which has to do with whether those who want an outcome have the power and means to achieve it. And there is commitment to preferences. So political will basically exists a sufficient set of decision makers with a common understanding of a particular problem on the formal agenda is committed a commonly perceived potentially effective policy solution. So that political will includes a sufficient set of decision makers. So it would be it can be with a common understanding of a particular problem on the formal agenda. It committed to supporting a commonly perceived potentially effective policy solution. So these were the political will, and if there is any lack of political will, that becomes the major barrier in implementing a policy in Pakistan. There are so many other barriers, but the most and the major barriers that literally obstacles in implementing a policy in Pakistan, these are three of these. So the faulty governance and lack of resources. I would say, if there is a government that is not running its functions effectively, they have bad governance, they have bad political system, they don't have any stable government, they don't have any political stability, they don't have any political balanced in the government system and administration. So that becomes the faulty governance, and that does not perform and observe its duties properly and effectively, and there comes the lack of resources. These two factors, the faulty governance and the lack of resources, they become the major barrier in implementing a policy in Pakistan. They are the major barrier. This point is one of the major barriers in implementing a policy in Pakistan, because we all know that if a government sometimes promises that when we will take over the government, we will fulfill your demands, we will fulfill your expectations, but at the end of the day, the government comes and it does not fulfill the promises of the public, it does not come up to the mark of the expectation of the people. So that becomes the faulty government, and there must be a balance between the resources and the population. But if the population is more and the sources are low, so that is imbalancement of resources. There must be equal distribution of resources among the different institutions of Pakistan, so that there must not be any lack of any resources, because they play an important role in fulfilling the policy in Pakistan. Because we all know that the money, the financial aid or the budget is the one major point that helps to implement a policy in Pakistan, not only in Pakistan but to other countries as well. But now I'm restricted to the boundaries of Pakistan. So there must be enough resources, there must be stable government. If the government would be stable, then the resources would be automatically equally there. There would not be any lack of resources. So these three are the major barriers that stops the process of implementation of a policy in Pakistan.